Hello students, welcome to the session. So in today's session we are going to deal on paper 5 unit 1, that is nothing but finding the solution for linear differential equations. So we were solving the problems and finding the solutions, right? So I have said different methods to find YP, right? That is nothing but the particular solution. But in one problem need not be, there is no necessity that you have to use this method itself. Using only one method, that problem will be solved and finished. It is not like that. In one problem, you may use three methods, or you may use any one method and finish it off. Any way is possible. So we'll solve one problem so you will understand what I'm going to say. So solve y double dash plus y is equal to 12 cos 2x minus sin x. So in this we have to find the general solution. So to find the general solution, we have to find the complementary as well as the particular solution, as I already said. So this complementary solution, auxiliary equation is must. So this I can write it as d square plus 1 into y is equal to 0, or m square, that is the auxiliary equation, equal to 0. So m square is equal to minus 1. This implies m is nothing but plus or minus I. So our, what is our complementary solution? Yc is equal to c1 cos x plus c2 sin x. Now the work is finding the particular solution. So to find the particular solution, yp is equal to, I am having 12 cos 2x and one more is minus sin x. In the previous one session, I have already said you, if we are having like this, we can split and find the particular solution. Particular solution of this one first, it may be y1 and yp1, and particular solution of this one and yp2. And sum of these two will be nothing but the particular solution of the given equation or given problem. Here either you can find first the particular solution of only 12 cos 2x separately, then minus sin x separately, or you can do it together also. So we'll do it together at once. So we'll get 1 by d square plus 1 into 12 cos 2x minus 1 by d square plus 1 into sin x. So observe here this I can write it as 1 square also, right? So here a is nothing but 1 and b is nothing but 2, right? But here you observe this is 1. Here if the coefficient is not there, means it is nothing but 1 itself. So here a is also 1, b is also 1. For your convenience, I will rewrite this. I can rewrite it as 12 into 1 by d square plus 1 square into cos 2x minus 1 by d square plus 1 into sin x. Observe here. In this, a is not equal to b, right? A is 1, b is 2. A is not equal to b. But in this case, a is equal to b. A is equal to. So here you have to use the formula when a is not equal to b. Here you have to use the formula when a is equal to b. So here 12 into, when a is not equal to b, what is the formula? 1 by a square minus b square into the cos 2x. So the same thing, that is 1 square minus 2 square into cos 2x minus 1 by, here both are same. When both are same, what is the formula for sin x? That is nothing but minus x by 2a into cos ax. So I'll consider a bracket, minus x by 2a, that is 1, into cos ax, that is 1x. So here you will obtain as 12 into 1 minus 4, so minus 1 by 3 into cos 2x. Here it becomes minus into minus as plus, so x by 2 into cos x. So if I further simplify, I'll get minus 4 cos 2x plus x by 2 into cos x. So this is nothing but the particular solution. So what is the general solution? General solution is nothing but y is equal to yc plus yp, that is c1 cos x plus c2 sin x minus 4 cos 2x plus x by 2 into cos x. So that is nothing but the general solution. So we'll solve one more problem so that you can understand better. So that is nothing but solve d square plus 2d plus 5 into y is equal to e power minus x into sin 2x. So finding the complementary solution, I'll not explain once again. Finding the complementary solution is one and the same. So you will get the roots of this equation as minus 1 plus or minus 2i. So you will get m as minus 1 plus or minus 2i. Here you have to use the formula method to find the roots of this equation. Okay, so what is a complementary solution? Complementary solution is e power minus x into plus or minus 2i. So c1 cos 2x plus c2 sin 2x. Now the work left is finding the particular solution. So to find the particular solution, see here, we were finding the problem when it was 1 by d square plus a square is equal to sine or cos term, right? But here it is with the e power x, there is sine. So what we have to use is, here first you have to use the method of shifting the exponential term, that is you will get e power x into d square plus 2d plus 5 into y is equal to sine 2x. Once you complete this method, then you have to use the method 1 by d square plus a square into sine ax method. So here we use two methods to find the particular solution of this problem. Okay, thank you.